led you to want to start the company or solving your own problem? I know we talked a little bit about it, but give us a window.
Yeah, so I didn't start Tusol as just thinking that I was going to go in there as a business. Mm-hmm. It was more of I had a lot of struggle. I struggled with a lot of IBS issues, one of them being Crohn's disease. And I also had postpartum depression, and I had a heterotopic pregnancy. And for those of you that don't know what a heterotopic pregnancy is, basically a simultaneous pregnancy with an implantation on another site. So mine was in the fallopian tube, so that one had to be removed. And so it was basically Humpty Dumpty, and I had so many issues. And so I was looking to, like many people, and there's a whole movement of biohacking. I don't know if you're familiar with that, mm-hmm. but the whole movement of stop relying on other people or outside sources to fix you. It's connecting back with your body and trying to fix yourself, trying to connect the dots. And so I was left like that, trying to connect the dots, because I went through so many doctors, went through so many surgeries trying to figure out. And the only answer that I was getting was, well, this is how you are. These are your genetics. There's nothing you can do about it.
Wow.
And so just imagine going through an expert and an expert telling you that. You start
I'd
to
fire them. I would just fire everybody if they said that to me.
Right? You start to believe that. And then you go into the, I started going on Google and researching Crohn's, and there was no, every website said it cannot be cured. It cannot mm-hmm. be cured. This is uncurable. And so just imagine, I said to myself, there's no way. There has to be an answer to this. There has to be a way out. Otherwise, I don't see myself surviving. I was, at that time, I was basically my rock bottom. I told myself that year, if I don't do anything, because it's very painful. If you don't know anyone with Crohn's disease, I'm just going to tell you a little bit about it. It's so painful that everything that you eat feels like a Brillo pad going through your intestines. And you can't have relationships with people, because if I'm trying to talk to you, like I'm talking to you now, I would constantly be thinking about my stomach hurting and excusing myself to the bathroom. And so there was no way I was able to have relationships with people. And at the time I was a brand new mom. And so the only thing that I cared about was to be a mom. It's like, how do I fix this issue so I could have the energy and I could have the bonding that I need to have with my son so I could be present? Because I was not present. I was mentally not there, and physically too. And so I had to figure it out of my own survival, and I couldn't rely on somebody else to fix me, because most of us want that doctor or that guru to figure out what is wrong with our bodies. And we're looking for that silver bullet to fix us. And then we just want to stay in that comfort zone. Okay, just give me that medicine so I could continue being in my comfort zone and I could continue living my regular life. So yeah, so I had that humbling experience of hitting the absolute rock bottom, which took me to a completely different journey in my life. So my background at the time, I was doing real estate and graphic design. So 6 years ago, I wouldn't have called it biohacking. I would have called it, a desperation to find an answer. So if you would have asked me at that time, because I was 29 years old at the time, it's like, Ingrid, how old are you? I would have told you, I feel like I'm 80 years old. If I went down the block, I would run out of breath. I couldn't lift anything. I felt like I was in bed pretty much most of the time. One realization that I had was, someone told me there's the best doctor in LA. This person is the best gastrointestinal doctor. You need to go to this person.
And, like a gastroenterologist?
Yes. I went to, it took me about 8 months to get an appointment. And I was like, she's going to fix me. This is it. This is going to be, she's going to tell me everything that's wrong with me. Mm. And then she's going to give me that she's going to fix me. So I walked in there, so excited. I had made a list of everything that I was eating, my routine. And then I walked into her consultation, and it took her 5 minutes. She looked at me. She goes, well, you have Crohn's, so I'm just going to prescribe you with steroids, and then come back and see me in another 6 months. And I looked at her. She was like walking me out of her office. I was like, well, wait. are you sure it has nothing to do with food? Like, I have a whole list here. She's like, no, honey, this has nothing to do with food. So just get the steroids and get out of my office, pretty much. I mean, I took the steroids and I was on them for, I wasn't on a lot of medications at the time. I mean, it fixed some of the Crohn issues, but it gave me an avalanche of other stuff. I mean, it made me worse. My depression, my suicidal thoughts was getting really, really bad. So I've never done New Year's resolution, but it was January when I said to myself, I have to do something because otherwise there's no point to live. There's no point to life. This is how sick I was. Mm-hmm. This is how debilitating. You tell a doctor, like, look, I can't even like think straight. My brain is super foggy. I'm tired. They would have sent me to a psychiatrist or to get a brain scan. But there's nothing wrong with the brain. There's just so much. My whole system was shut down. And so the first thing I did was, okay, I wrote down all the symptoms that I had. I have inflammation, because that's what Crohn's disease is, just chronic inflammation. I have gut dysbiosis. I have cognitive decline. I have oxidative stress. And I started making a list of my ailments. And I said, okay, so I know that Eastern medicine has alternatives. There's other stuff other than medications, because medications is basically plant medicine that has been synthetically done in a lab. It's completely isolated and super concentrated. So it throws you off balance, right? And so pharmaceutical companies cannot patent this plant medicines because you can't patent that. You can't make money off of it. Mm-hmm. And so I was looking into Chinese medicine, and I looked into Ayurveda medicine. I looked into Aztec medicine. And one of the things that I realized is like, well, these types of medicine have many commonalities. You know, the focus of the systems is on the person as a whole rather than the disease. Mm. So the systems fundamentally aim to promote health and enhance the quality of life. That's what it is. So because everything is connected and we just tend to isolate the symptom, treating it like it's a separate entity. But I like that concept of this really old schools of medicine. And so I started to look into plants. And I'm not talking about artichokes. I'm not talking about lettuce. I'm talking about the plants that we don't consume. You know, on your standard American diet, these plants don't exist. Most people don't even know what they are. And so I started looking into, okay, so what are these plants that are known to lower inflammation? So I started making a list. Okay, what are these plants that are known to enhance cognitive health? And so I started putting together recipes for myself. And at the time, I could only have smoothies, because if I had a bowl of solids, there's no way my stomach could break them down. And so I said, okay, so how can I have all these medicines as my breakfast? How can I mix them all into one single meal that I could assimilate and that I could, you know, that could help me, and I could diversify my diet? Because if you look at your diet, we pretty much eat the same thing every single day. That's our comfort food. We pretty much eat cauliflower 3 times a week. You just look at your diet and make a list, and it's basically the same. Mm-hmm. And so in order to diversify your gut and make your gut healthy, you need to feed your biome. And your biome need a lot of different antioxidants, different types of fibers. Fiber doesn't exist, it's fibers. And so you need all kinds of food that could enhance your gut. And so I started looking into that, and I started making myself these smoothies. And I want to say that within a month and a half after taking the smoothies every single day, I started seeing a really drastic change. I started to feel more energetic. I lost about 30 pounds. Most importantly, I was feeling more positive. The fog that I had in my brain was like completely opening up. And so I started to get super excited. And after like 2 months, people wouldn't recognize me. Mm. I would go down to the farmer's market and they would look at me and like, what did you do? Like, who are you? I want to know everything that you're doing. And so I started going around Malibu and sharing my smoothies to people. I was like, okay, just tell me what's wrong with you. I could figure out a smoothie based on your ailment.
Hey everyone, thanks for checking out that clip. If you enjoyed it, be sure to hit the like button down below. And if you're interested in hearing the full episode, it's out right now on our YouTube channel. We've had a lot of great guests come on this show before, and we've got a lot of great guests coming up in the future. So hit subscribe so that you don't miss a single episode. And one final note, we're always looking for new ideas and new companies to feature on the show. So if you know of someone or know of a company, write us a comment down below letting us know who they are and what they do. We'd be happy to have them on the show. Till then, I'll just be here waiting for your comments. So, see you later.